Good evening, I hope everybody's doing well, and we're going to talk to Lise.
Delara, great timing. I was just about to send word to the Scions. I've got lots to tell you. The Council has officially recognized Resistance as our standing army, and I expect you can guess who's been appointed commander. Quite set to say, we're in good hand. Having the Bull of Alamigo at the helm's done wonders for morale. People were dancing in the streets when the announcement was made, and we have you and the Sultana to thank for it. If you two hadn't worked your magic, he'd never have contemplated following his heart. The Council has also decreed that we're to maintain a presence at Rygal's Reach. Lise will continue to lead our forces in the fringes, a job she's been doing tirelessly, a bit too tirelessly, some might say. We're constantly having to remind her to rest before she falls over. That's an exaggeration. And I always get up again. Anyway, we can hardly afford to lower our guard now. Not after our latest brush with Lakshmi. Speaking of which, we've been keeping a close eye on the Koliana, and it looks like they've chosen a new leader. It's, Shanti's daughter. You know, the half-dead one. For whatever reason, the Koliana thought she was the best candidate, which makes them leaderless, basically. As things stand, there's no prospect of engaging in talks, let alone coming to an understanding. But I won't let that stop me. I'll keep on reaching out to them until they finally see sense. Just like I've been reaching out to Fordola. She still won't meet my gaze, but she's given up trying to ignore me. It may only be the odd grunt, but at least she's responding. I'll get through her yet. Delara, there you are. Alphanel, Alizé, is everything alright? We've received word from Tataru. Hancock has apparently acquired information of great interest and urgency. More than that, she didn't say, only that we should come to Kugane right now. I had a mind for the two of us to set forth together, but Alizé is determined to make it a party of three. As I've told you more than a dozen times, brother, my wounds are quite healed, and I would benefit from some fresh air. Oof. Besides, you may well need an extra pair of hands. Worry not, sister. I have quite given up trying to convince you. Whether we be two or three, we should depart as soon as possible. You will be joining us, I trust. Huh. I was about to say I'd come too, but I'll just have to settle for cheering you on from afar. Good luck with whatever it turns out to be. Thank you, Lise. Rest assured, should this business prove to be of even tangential concern to Alamigo, we shall inform you without delay. Let us be off then. Hancock and Tataru await us at the Ruby Bazaar offices.
My friends, thank you for coming at such short notice.
We were told the matter was urgent. I take it Yugiri and Soroban are also involved?
My presence here is but a happy coincidence. I am come on separate business, which can wait.
My apologies. Master Hancock, pray, tell our friends exactly what you told me.
Of course, of course. Some few days ago, a large detachment of soldiers was seen arriving at the Garlean Embassy. This seemed to me most unusual, as no personages of note are due to visit for a matter of months. So, I made a few inquiries, whereupon I learned of a most curious rumor. Apparently, the soldiers were dispatched to Kugane to investigate recent sightings of a certain individual. The late acting Imperial Viceroy of Doma, Yotsuyu.
I beg your pardon?
I too am loath to believe it. I saw the keep come down on top of her. We all did.
I would not presume to question your eyewitness accounts, nor am I one to take rumors at face value. The fact is, the Garlians have no knowledge of what took place at Dorma Castle. They may well be chasing after a woman who merely resembles Yotsuyu. But a woman who resembles Yotsuyu in the company of a grizzled Rogadin samurai? I dare say that thickens the plot.
Gosetsu! He's alive!
While I've no conclusive proof, I thought that such a possibility warranted your attention.
Have you informed Lord Hien? Well, I think we'd all like to believe the old bear survived.
Indeed. While I dare not give myself wholly to hope, I will not deny that I have prayed for such a miracle ever since that fateful day. But regardless of my personal feelings, if the Empire has seen fit to pursue these rumors so vigorously, we can scarce afford to ignore them. I am bound by duty to ascertain the truth of the matter. Will you join me in this quest? Thank you. If Gosetsu yet lives, he will need our help if he is to avoid capture.
Gosetsu is a dear friend, and we cannot abandon him to the mercy of the Empire. Our course is clear. Hancock, is there aught else you can tell us?
Alas, not. But I have taken the liberty of employing one of the finest informants money can buy. You shall have the latest intelligence on the Garlean's movements and more besides.
The informant awaits your pleasure in the back streets of Sanjo Hanamachi. From its shining facade to its dark underbelly, few know Kugane as intimately as he. One of the finest informants money can buy. Why do I have a bad feeling about this?
Permit me to assist you in your quest, my friends. The sooner your business is concluded, the sooner we may speak of mine. Should your search take you away from Kugane, my boat is at your disposal. I shall see that she is ready to sail.
I'll give Soriban a hand. If he's providing us a ship, the least we can do is supply the provisions. We'll be at the pier if you need us. A welcome offer and an excellent plan. Without further ado, then, let us seek out this informant in Sanjo Hanamachi. This should be the place. Now we wait and see who comes.
It has been a while, my friends. Yes, yes, a long while indeed.
Squeaky, squeaky.
I knew it. Gyodo, any funny business and you know what will happen, I trust.
No funny business, only loyal service and the finest quality information. Of course, such quality does not come cheap.
No, but then Hancock already paid you. Honestly, you must think we were born yesterday. I have half a mind to call Lise.
No Lise, I beg you, no boots. I will tell you everything I know, free of charge. The Empire searches for Yotsuyu, high and low, far and wide. Come to enlist my help, they did, promising rich rewards for decisive information.
And have you decisive information? Were the two individuals sighted here indeed Gosetsu and Yotsuyu?
Alas, see them with my own eyes, I did not. But the Imperials are confident, yes, very confident indeed. Look at the size of their contingent. But here is something they do not know, a rumor which you will find most interesting, I think. They say an utterly Rogadin samurai appeared on Kugane Dori with a beauteous maiden and sold his katana to a pawnbroker. It was no common katana either, but one of surpassing craftsmanship.
Well, that is interesting. assuming it's true. Did you corroborate the rumor with the pawnbroker in question?
No. Regrettably, I do not have a working relationship with the master of Shofuku Shichiten.
Now, why would that be, I wonder? If I didn't know better, I think he lent you money.
He will help you, I'm certain. While you speak with him, I will make contact with my Garlean connections and learn what I can of their progress.
A glimpse of the blade is all I need to be sure. But is it wise to let the Namazu out of our sight?
No other choice but this, and a fine choice it is. Though I am adept at gathering information, it is so much more efficient to share the work.
He's right. Given the urgency, we would do well to split up. And so I will go with our friend here. Nothing improves efficiency like a little supervision.
Yes, we will go together, and there will be no boots.
Let's be about it then. Good luck with the katana. Shall we reconvene at the pier later on? Fragrant as the Ruby Bazaar offices are, I prefer the fresh air. I believe Alize has her task well in hand. Shall we seek out the pawnbroker? Everything in order? Then let us proceed to Koganedori and find the master of Shofuku Shichiten. Welcome, good madam. Welcome. Will you be buying or... Ah, so you have heard tell of the Rogaden Samurai's katana. Small wonder, it is a fine example of its kind. One moment. Dari, hope you have found our pawnbroker. Excellent work, Dalara. And that is the katana. There can be no doubt. It is Gosetsu's blade. The craftsmanship is exquisite, is it not? And you will be pleased to know that the pledge has just expired. I should be glad to sell it to you, assuming you have the coin. This is no ordinary weapon, you understand, and it is priced accordingly. But if you are serious, I suggest you act quickly, as several noted collectors have already expressed an interest. The blade represents conclusive proof of Gosetsu's survival. I suppose this could be considered a necessary cost in securing his safe return. Yet, it is not a decision I can make alone, least of all when our nation has scarce begun to rebuild. Nay, my friend, grateful though I am for the offer, I cannot ask this of you. It is enough to know that Gosetsu is alive and well.
Yugiri, wait. The Scions will buy the katana. Pray consider it a gift.
Master Afuno, your kindness is touching, truly. Yet matters of coin, would Mistress Ataru not expect to be consulted?
Come now. Our friend would never have relinquished his blade were the need not great. And we are not bound by honor to help a friend in need.
I say we are, and I am sure Ataru will wholeheartedly agree.
It's settled then. You have made a wise choice, my friend. Such pieces are few and far between. Now, if you would be so good as to come this way, I shall prepare the necessary papers.
If I may ask, sir, after he visited your establishment, do you perchance know where the old samurai went? He's our friend, and we would return his weapon to him.
A friend of yours, you say? I see. Well, then, I suppose there can be no harm in telling you. No sooner had I provided him with the requested sum than his pretty young companion began clamoring for Dango, a duly recommended, though served at the Yumineko Tea House, and thither did they set off. Ah.
Clamoring for Dango? Can these truly be the same people? It makes no sense. Some manner of code, perhaps, but it avails us not to speculate. Let us go to this tea house and see if we can pick up their trail.
But of course I remember. How could I forget a pair like that?
the most beautiful girl you'll ever see, scoffing down Dango as if her life depended on it while the old samurai looked on. Not quite what he expected, I'll wager. Far be it for me to gossip about my customers, but he was planning to spirit her away across the Ruby Sea. Out of the reach of her family, no doubt. When the girl had finally had her fill, they set off in the direction of the Chiyokaze hostelry, presumably to find someone discreet with a boat. Segosetsu makes for Doma. But this woman who travels with him, the more I hear about her, the more I wonder if she can truly be Yotsuyu. While doubts remain over the identity of Gosetsu's traveling companion, for now we can but follow the trail. Come, let us away to the pier and make ready to sail. With luck, Alize will already have joined Master Soroban and Mistress Ataru there.
Excellent timing, my friends. Mistress Alize arrived mere moments ago.
All went well at my end. Gyoto met with an Imperial officer and wielded his way to some new information. It seems the troop who recently arrived in Kugani came directly from Garlemald. The Imperials based here have been kept in the dark. And that's not all. A contingent of the aforementioned troops are preparing for deployment to the Ruby Sea. If I didn't know better, I'd say they picked up Gosetsu's trail. Then your information matches ours. We are quite certain that Gosetsu seeks to cross to the mainland.
I'm sorry, did I hear that right? You used Scion funds to buy Gosetsu's katana at the asking price?
We were in some haste and it seemed a worthwhile gesture. Speaking of which, here's the contract of sale. Pray see that the man is paid.
Thal's beard! You agreed to this? Give me strength.
Well, it's not like the search can wait. You best be on your way.
But Alfano, we need to talk. I want you to come straight to the offices as soon as you get back. Promise me.
Oh, very well. I shall call upon you as soon as I return.
First, let us go to the Ruby Price. If Gosetsu has already set sail, the sentries there are sure to have seen him.
Ataru seemed rather vexed, did she not? Ever the melodramatist, I am sure our finances can stretch to a single sword. Remind me to explain the value of such gestures when we next see her. But I digress, we have work to do.
Right. I suggest we begin by learning what we can from the sentries. What's going on out there?
Travelers, are you? You may wish to postpone your plans. The Garlians have launched an attack on the Confederacy. We have no reason to believe they'll turn their attention here, but for your own safety, I suggest you return to Kugane.
The Garlians bear no love for the Confederacy, but with Doma lost to them, why would they attack? Unless...
Unless Yotsuyu is on that island.
Even if she isn't, our allies are under attack and they need our help.
We will help them while you remain with Soroban. Arguing will only delay us. Is that clear?
Fine, but you haven't heard the last of this.
Soroban, we may need to make a swift exit. See that the boat is ready to sail at a moment's notice.
It shall be done.
What, and you're going to swim there, are you?
'Tis the quickest way, and you may rest assured I've been practicing.
Yeah!
Come.
An opening. Your defense is lacking. Leave this to me!
Lady Yotsuyu, we're here to rescue you. Please, come with us.
Stay back, Tsuyu.
Are you all right?
Is he all right?
Gosetsu!
Damn it! We took too long. Change of plan. Eliminate hostiles! All forces, attack!
Thank you.
The art of my forebears. Gosetsu, thank the heavens!
Yugiri, my friends, the kami were kind to guide your steps this way.
It's over. The Imperials are retreating. I suppose we have you to thank for that. But they would never have come here were it not for her. I had a bad feeling the moment your samurai friend arrived with that woman in tow.
Do not be afraid, Suyu. These people are my friends.
Friends?
Forgive me, but at the risk of souring the mood, I believe you owe us an explanation. You may start by telling us what happened at Doma Castle.
Of course. I'll not begrudge you that. As you know, we were trapped inside the keep when it collapsed. But even as the roof crumbled above us, so too did the floor below. We were swept out into the One River, where we would surely have drowned had a stout wooden door not chanced to float by, offering us a raft of sorts. Exhausted, we drifted out to sea, at the mercy of the tides, which saw fit to dispense us on a desert island.
She was with you the entire time?
Aye. 'Twas her kimono which saved her from Hien's blade, believe it or not. Some Garlean witchcraft in the weave. But it offered precious little protection against the fall. Though she survived, she awoke bereft of all her memories, and speaking like a child.
A trick, surely.
That was my first thought, And I contemplated cutting her down and being done with it. Contemplated it long and hard. Yet the kami saw fit to deliver us from certain death. 'Twas their will that we survive, both of us, together. And together we shall go before our master. He shall be the one to judge.
Judge what?
She's your prisoner, old man. Do with her as you will. Call her Tsuyu, or whatever else tickles your fancy.
'Twas a name given out of necessity whilst on the road. Nothing more.
As you say. But remember this. Our people suffered much at that woman's hands. When the time comes, I trust you won't let emotion blind you to what needs to be done.
You have my word.
Well, I must be going. I have an unholy mess to clean up. You should be on your way too, before the Imperials decide to take another tilt. Oh, and we'll overlook the tithe this once. You're welcome.
As Tansui says, we should move on. It would not do for Yotsuyu to be seen here. Now, if I know my sister, she will already be waiting with the boat at the nearby pier. Let's go and see if I'm right. Gosetsu, thank the god you're safe. It was all I could do to watch the battle from afar.
And it was all I could do to restrain her.
Can you blame me for worrying? Strong as Dallara is, anything could happen in the chaos. But enough about me. We need to talk about her. Greetings? They tell me you've lost your memory, and that's fine. But I want you to know something. I won't be taking my eyes off you, not for a moment. These people are strange. Are you sure they're your friends?
I am. They may behave strangely, but I trust them with my life. You have naught to fear.
Not for like a certain like this no more.
Alright, if you say so. Right. Tis past time we set sail. I, for one, would not keep Lord Hien waiting without due cause.
Aye, and the longer we tarry, the more we risk inviting trouble. Lest you forget, the Red Kojin bear no love for Yotsuyu either. I shall deliver you to familiar shores, near Asari, but out of the village's sight. Here is where we part ways, my friends. I pray the remainder of your journey passes uneventfully. Dallara, when you are not otherwise occupied, I would speak with you about my next business venture. It promises to be extremely lucrative, and I do not say so lightly. After the prodigious sums spent acquiring a certain sword, it would present a fine opportunity to refill the Scion's coffers, and restore the smile to Mistress Tataru's face.
Oh, come along! Tataru was overreacting. How much could a single katana possibly cost?
Far more than you think, plainly.
A blade like Osetsu is worth a fortune, enough to buy a house and furnish it, which you would know had you bothered to check the price.
What? I had no idea.
This business venture is Soroban's. You will give it fair hearing, I trust. He has been good to us, after all. As for me, I think I shall look into drawing upon my personal funds.
We must meet with Lord Hien as soon as possible, though mayhap not at the Enclave. I will send word requesting that he receive us at the House of the Fears, where there are fewer prying eyes. If we all are in agreement, I shall scout ahead and see that the way is clear. Pray follow us swiftly as you are able, and join me on the outskirts of Namai.
All is well? Good. The others are hiding nearby. Let us proceed. Quietly, if you please.
My Lord Hien, I am returned.
Save your tears for the morrow, for we who yet walk the path should not think too much on the destination. When the hour arrives, we shall welcome what comes with open arms. And welcome it you did, even as the keep fell down around us. At that moment, in your smile, I spied a shred of hope, one which I have clung to ever since. Gorsetsu, full glad am I to see you alive and well.
We have played this scene before, have we not? Though this time our roles are reversed.
That they are. Meaning you know how I feel. Wholly at a loss for words. Welcome back, old friend. Now then, though we rejoice at your return, it seems you have brought with you certain complications. Rise, my friend. Tell me everything. The Empire is bold indeed to send a token force to engage the Confederacy.
As acting Viceroy, Yotsuyu would have been privy to Imperial secrets. The Garlians will not soon give up the chase.
Nay, it'll end with her capture, or her death.
Are you a friend too?
She claims to have lost her memory, though I know not if she speaks true. I brought her here that you might decide her fate.
Lost her memory, you say? Regardless, the people have not forgotten. Her face yet haunts their dreams. She cannot roam free. We will hold her here for a time. Place her in Jufia's care, with the express instruction that she is not to be seen.
Yes, my lord. Come.
No, I don't want to. Don't let her take me away!
It's all right, Soyu. I will come with you. Be a good girl, and listen to Yugiri.
From a hound at his throat to a puppy at his heel. If this is an act, it is a remarkable performance.
Thank you for delivering Gosetsu back to us in one piece. We are lucky indeed to have friends who would journey to the other side of the world to help us, and repeatedly at that. We have much and more to think upon, but as regards to the Empire, we can but watch and wait. Now then, seeing as you've come all this way, you must allow me to show you around the Enclave. I would not have you thinking we've been idle in your absence. The rebuilding effort proceeds apace, I'm pleased to say, and we are now ready to welcome home our countrymen who are displaced by the war. Do they so desire it, there is a place here for those who fled to Eorzea. We should be delighted to accept your invitation, Lord Hien, and I have no doubt that your subjects at Revenant's Toll will be heartened to hear that their lord has not forgotten them. Whew. Oh, it's nothing.
I just thought that Gosetsu and Yugiri would be back by now. Forgive me, my lord, but Captain Jufuya, I already forgot how you pronounce that, Jufuya is nowhere to be found. Oh? He was here when I arrived. For now, we have taken Yotsuya to a private chamber and assigned another to watch over her, my lord. But I find it passing strange that the captain should leave his post with nary a word. That does seem most unusual. If you mean to look for the man, we will be happy to assist you. We should be glad of the help. While I search without, mayhap you could ask our soldiers here if they know anything. I will join you. With respect, my lord, you should remain here. Should the Empire move against us, you will be better able to coordinate our response. Ha! And there I was thinking I was in charge. But you had the right of it. Go on then. I will mind the house. You see the captain? He passed by a little while ago. I wondered if I should tell someone as it happens. He did not look well, you see. I asked if that was the matter and he told me the pass had caught up with him. But I doubt it was that. There are older men in our ranks.
Captain Jufuya? He was headed for the northern entrance when I saw him last. I was going to invite him to train with us, but he did not hear me call out to him. If you need him, I dare say the sentry on duty will be able to tell you more. Indeed, I suggested as much to Mistress Alizé when she came asking earlier. Is something amiss? Aye, the captain went outside some bells ago, and looking quite unwell, I am sorry to say. This I mentioned to Lord Gosetsu, who straightway struck out after him. I hope they will be alright.
Gosetsu too? It seems everyone has been on joining the surge. That's all well and good, but someone has to stay behind. There's no telling what the Empire is plotting. You go on, Delara. Alf and I know shall hold the fort.
Ah! By the Kami! Your Lord Hien! Leave me! Leave me, I beg of you! Say nothing of this! I was never here!
There you are.
Lady Yugiri! Lord Gosetsu, forgive me my abrupt disappearance.
You have your reasons, I am sure. Will you not share them?
I was her master when she was yet a courtesan.
By the Kami.
She worked in my establishment. Her father was a regular client of mine. One day, quite without preamble, he offered to sell her to me. She may be no maiden, he said, but she has some use left in her. He sold her short. When I first beheld her, I was struck by her beauty. And yet, behind her eyes, there was an emptiness. It was as if she had given up on life. She seemed more a doll than a woman. It was no profession for her, but I knew she would be popular. And so it proved. Men flocked to drown themselves in that cold, bottomless gaze. The rest you know. She became an Imperial informant, and for her loyal service won the office of Acting Viceroy.
Well, you came to serve the Liberation Front.
Tis said that the atrocities Yotsuyu committed were driven by vengeance. If so, I bear part of the blame for creating the monster she became. Joining the Front was meant to be my atonement. But the truth is, I am a coward, whose only thought was to escape her wrath, then as now.
I see. Then I shall recommend that you be assigned to a new post. I trust you have no objections, Yulgiri?
None. It would not do to leave Yotsuyu in his care.
I am in your debt.
Who is it that you seek to protect, Kosetsu? Idle musings. Pray, pay me no mind.
Forgive me. Now is not the time for brooding. Come, let us rejoin the others.
I thank you for your help in the search. Gosetsu has told me all that transpired. I would not presume to defend the life of Fuya, led before he joined the front. Nor will I condemn it. Frankly, it is not my place to judge. I will only say this. The Jofuya I know has ever been a man of courage. That he should feel driven to flee bespeaks the depth of his terror. Even now, Yotsuyu casts a shadow over the realm. But the question of what is to be done with her must wait. The Empire is on the move once more. While you're out searching for Fuya, I'll just say Fuya, Jesus, we receive word from our shinobi allies. An Imperial airship has been sighted over Domen soil. Our visitor's objective remains unclear. It may be another attempt to recover Yotsuyu, or a prelude to invasion. Either way, the craft reportedly advances at speed and appears bound for Kashram Fluminous. I mean to go there and ascertain their intent. If we ride out in force, it will only end one way, so we shall keep our numbers to a minimum. Yugiri, Delara, can I count on you?
Yes, my lord.
Alizé and I would fain play our part as well. We will not stand idly by while a common foe threatens the lands of our friends and allies.
We will be glad of the help. You are acquainted with Hakuro, I believe. Then I bid you seek him out and assist in maintaining order in the Enclave. When the people see an Imperial airship, they are liable to panic. I would have you reassure them and, should it come to it, aid in their excavation.
Evacuation, blah.
Very well, we shall depart at once. Do take care.
What of me, my lord?
The Empire may well be after Yotsuyu. You are to remain here and guard her until my return.
As you wish. Pray stay close to Delara and Yugiri.
Well. Guard duty and not a breath of protest. Now I have seen it all.
The Kashram Fluminous, then. Let us find out what the Empire's game is.
The area secure. Whatever our visitor's purpose, they plainly believe they can achieve it alone. The craft should come into view at any moment. Let us await them inside the Kashram.
A smoke signal? Thoughts, Yugiri?
In former times, such signals were used to announce the coming of an emissary of peace. In Doma, at least. But could that truly be their intent?
Who can say? Whatever they want, we cannot simply blast them out of the sky. Not when they were so gracious as to honor one of our cherished traditions. I would not have it said that we Dormans want for propriety.
Then I shall go and reconnoiter.
Nay, that won't be necessary. We will meet them openly. I would welcome this student of Dorman history in person, whomsoever he or she may be.
As you wish, my lord. I shall arrange for a signal of our own to be fired in answer.
We should be received by the Lord of Dorma himself.
I but afford an emissary of peace, the courtesy he is due. Welcome to Dorma, my lord.
Ah, where are my manners? I am Asahi Sas Brutus, ambassador plenipotentiary of Garlemald.
He is heir to the Nyuri clan, and Yotsu's stepbrother.
It seems I need not introduce myself, not in the presence of the famed Yugiri Mistwalker. Your skills as a shinobi are known far and wide, my lady. It is true, the former acting viceroy is my sister, yet bonds of kinship aside, we have precious little in common. As will soon become plain, I come not to sow strife, but to end it. I am of the Populares, a collective which represents the interests of the common man. Long have we labored to bring about reform to the Empire's provincial policy. Happily for us, our master acknowledges the need for change. Indeed, his radiance, Emperor Varys Zos Galvus, personally sanctioned this mission, granting me the authority to speak with his voice. To negotiate peace with Dorma.
Well then, we have much to discuss. Will you accompany me to my hall?
Gladly, my lord.
We shall escort our guests across the river to the enclave. Yugiri. Pray go on ahead to the Uzuki Manor docks and see that the ferries are ready. You guys left it unattended. Can I ride inside? Aw, it's hollow. Lord Hien and I will accompany the Imperial delegation on the first ferry. When you are ready, speak with the boatman and join us on the other side. There you are, Delara. So, first things first. What do you think of the Enclave? I must say I'm quite proud of what my countrymen have accomplished in the time. We even have an ether right now, courtesy of the Onishisu. Be sure and attune to it, would you? Once it has the Warrior of Light's seal of approval, people might actually start using the thing. But on to the matter at hand. The ambassador and his retinue are at my hall, taking their ease ahead of the negotiations. I want you there when the talking starts. It will serve to send a message to the Empire that Eorzea and Dorma stand united. I am not normally one for hollow posturing, But in this game of nations, such gestures carry weight.
Oh, and should you feel uneasy about speaking for the Scions, Alphino and Alizé will also be there. You need only eat, drink, and look imposing. Say you'll come.
I knew I could count on you. When you are ready, come and join me at my humble abode, the CanCon. The guardsmen will see you in.
On behalf of my delegation, I offer you my humblest thanks. Never did I imagine that I would meet the gallant and noble Lord of Dorma himself, nor be welcomed into his magnificent hall.
You'll forgive me if we forgo the pleasantries. You say you are come to negotiate peace. Unless I am mistaken, such negotiations are typically conducted between sovereign nations. I was not aware that the Emperor had recognized Dorma's sovereignty.
His Radiance has yet to do so, that much is true. Know, however, that he has expressed willingness to cede Dorma to her ancestral masters and treat with her as a friend. Since the days of Emperor Solus, the Empire has aggressively expanded its territory. While you may not agree with our Founding Father's policy of expansion, I believe there is room for discussion on the matter of his lifelong goal, to rid the world of icons. Icons are a blight upon this star. They cannot be suffered to exist. This you know as well as we. In his wisdom, Emperor Varus wishes to explore the possibility of an alliance to combat this common threat. On the condition that Dorma renounces summoning and pledges to police the Corgian's practice of it, his Radiance would extend the hand of friendship.
Dorma has never shown any appetite for summoning, and it should go without saying that we will address any threat to our people, icon or otherwise. With regard to the Corgin, I must stress that they only resorted to summoning under extreme provocation. When the Ruby Sea was at peace and their sacred relics safe, they looked not to their kami for protection. Yet even now, there are certain parties who would destabilize the region with ill-conceived military forays. Unless they alter their course, we cannot hope to be rid of icons.
Quite. I can but apologize. In seeking to eliminate icons, the Empire creates them. Tis an irony among ironies. One with which the people of Eorzea are well acquainted, I am told.
Indeed, many summonings are the result of persecution, the weak being driven to call upon the divine for deliverance from the strong. So it was in Alamigo, the bitter fruit of Garlean oppression.
A tragic state of affairs. If we are to put an end to summoning once and for all, it shall not be through might, but harmony. Yet we continue to repeat our mistakes, oblivious to the lessons of history. My comrades and I would change all that. We Populares have campaigned long and hard for a shift in imperial policy. And at last, the Emperor has seen fit to lend us an ear. Alas, there is a faction within Garlemald that would obstruct our every attempt at reform. A collection of pure-blooded Garlians who seek to consolidate their own supremacy. The Optimates. Lest you wonder, theirs was the hand that loosed our forces on the Confederacy. 'Twas a regrettable incident, one that flies in the face of everything we believe. And I swear to do all in my power to prevent a reoccurrence.
That would be most welcome. But if I may speak plain, if the Empire itself is not of one mind, how can we be certain that any peace we negotiate will be honored?
I cannot blame you for doubting us. Indeed, I should find it strange if you did not. And so, in the name of building trust, I would like to make a proposal. A prisoner exchange. Under Garlian rule, no few Dormans were conscripted into the Imperial Army. We would repatriate them in return for those of ours you captured in the recent conflict. Naturally, any exchange would include the acting viceroy.
Yotsu? What makes you think we have her?
Forgive me, my lord. Was it not your wish to speak plain? Let us not play games. I desire only to work to our mutual benefit. The Optimates tried and failed to take my sister by force. I would succeed by peaceable means, thereby strengthening my party's hand. 'Twould be a lie to say I would not also be glad of my sister's safe return.
A fellow plain speaker. How refreshing. Very well. Your proposal has merit, but I will need time to consider it.
Of course, my lord. May we remain in Dorma until you have come to a decision?
You shall be our honored guests. Yugiri, I leave the ambassador and his retinue in your care. See that they are well looked after.
You have our gratitude, Lord Hien. We shall look forward to your answer.
Well, that was unexpected. You can say that again. I still don't know quite what to make of it all, but on the surface, a prisoner exchange does seem a good way to begin. The question is, can they be trusted? They had not to gain by divulging the details of their internal divisions. As it stands, we have no reason to doubt them. But the ambassador's mention of Yotsuyu left me ill at ease. It made his grand talk of peace seem uncannily like a lengthy preamble. You think this might all be a ruse to facilitate her retrieval? Perhaps. Though I cannot fathom why they would go to such lengths. Yotsuyu may have been the acting viceroy, but she is not the Garlian, nor even highborn. Her value must presumably lie in what she knows. Which brings us to the little matter of her memory loss. In her present condition, she would not yield any worthwhile intelligence, nor is she worth much as a bargaining piece. Alphino, you are well acquainted with the Empire's methods. I would have your thoughts on this matter. My knowledge is at your disposal, Lord Hien. While the Ambassador's proposal is appealing in principle, it would be remiss of us not to give it due scrutiny. Indeed, though it seems to me I have little choice but to accept regardless. With so many of our brothers and sisters languishing in Imperial camps, I cannot well turn my back on a chance to secure their repatriation. Only the Kami know when I will be afforded another. But ere we continue, shall we excuse these two? I fear what follows will bore them to tears. I was just about to show myself out as it happens. Come on, Delara,
Let's leave Alfano to dispense his copious knowledge.
Someone is still sore from being made to watch a Sakazuki.
Go on, and keep Alize company. We are safe enough for now. A chance to relax at last. I know when I'm out of my depth, Alara. Though no weapons are drawn, a negotiation is no less a battle, and the stakes can be every bit as high. One misplaced word and people could die. It takes someone with a cool head, and I'll be the first to admit that's not me. So we're left with the eternal question. What to do while they prattle on? Alright, for want of a better suggestion, let's say you to a brief tour of the newly liberated Doma. I'd be interested to hear how the people are faring in their own words, and it's not as if we'll be missed here, or will we? Lara, a moment, if you would. Ah, Yugiri, and Asahi, was it? You have some business with Lara. Business? No, pleasure, my lady. I merely wish to exchange a few words with the famed Slayer of Gods and Champion of Eorzea. It is truly an honor. Such heartfelt admiration. One could almost forget that you're an envoy of the Empire. Oh? Is that so strange? We may have stood on opposing sides in the past, but I see no contradiction in allowing the woman who would do battle with our common enemy. Unless you forget, this is my homeland. It would be remiss of me not to at least thank her for containing the threat posed by the Kojin's vile icon. Now, if I may continue as we speak, Lord Heian deliberates over my proposal, and I would take this time to see the land I once called home. Though Lady Yugiri is certain to be a jovial escort, the excursion would be all the more enjoyable for your company, and safer besides. The ambassador has the right of it. He does not like to come to harm with you at his side. Will you join us? In that case, I will join you as well. There is not else to do until Lord Heian has reached his decision, and I can think of no finer way to learn more about the current state of Doma. That's settled then. The four of us shall make a brief excursion through Azantia. Might we start at the town of Munzen? I would see what has become of Doma Castle. Very well, if you will follow me. Nay, can this truly be Munzen, home to the cream of Doma samurai? I'd heard that Yotsuyu intended to send some few of our automata here, but only by way of warning. It should not have come to this. Indeed, her savagery served only to incense the people and spur them to rise up in protest. It was folly to think such methods of governance could ever prove effective. The sooner we can begin to make amends for the senseless destruction, the better. Securing supplies and support for the reconstruction effort should not prove difficult, once our nations are formally at peace, of course. Yes, of course. If you would have a better view of what remains of the castle, we must proceed through the ruins. It is a travesty. A travesty. I remember the keep being so beautiful. In the light of the setting sun, one would swear it was aflame. It is indeed a doleful spectacle. Mayhap we will rebuild it one day, when we have finished helping our people to rebuild their lives. Spoken like a true popularis. The needs of the people must of course come first. Speaking of whom, would you be opposed to my seeing how they live firsthand? The village of the Mai is but a short journey from here, if I'm not mistaken. By river, yes. If you will follow me, I will ready our bow.
Someone's in trouble.
Are you all right?
Hi.
What do they want with you?
You, Giddy. And you lot, too. I don't know. We were returning from the Enclave when they came at us.
It seems they won't go quietly.
And neither will we.
Of my forebears.
Seems to be the last of them. You have nothing to fear, child. You are safe now.
Thank you, sir.
You saved us again. Thank you. If you're ever passing by our village, look us up. You'll always be welcome.
Thank goodness we arrived when we did.
Indeed. But what could have prompted the Red Kojin to stray so far from the Ruby Sea?
I presume these are the sellswords hired by Yotsuyu. If so, the answer is simple. Desperation. Bereft of Imperial employment, they seek other means to line their coin purses. Another sad legacy of the Empire's mismanagement.
The Empire to which you have sworn allegiance.
Must you always be so pointed? If we are to bring about lasting change, we must look beyond narrow allegiances. You have every right to doubt me, but in time, I hope you will come to see that we share a common goal. You and yours have fought fiercely to change the Empire from without, but if we are to end the cycle of conflict, the Empire must change from within. Am I wrong? Never? I wonder, would you have said the same of Ishgard? Believe what you will, but I assure you, the Empire can change.
Dear me, I had hoped to convey my views on our nation's shared hopes under more peaceable circumstances. Yet this regrettable little interlude did afford me a chance to see the famed hero of Eorzea in action, and few Imperial soldiers can say that, at least few who live to tell the tale. Well, after that little ordeal, I believe it may be time for us to return to the Enclave. Return, my lord? What of Namai? You seem so eager to observe the villagers going about their daily lives. To be frank, I still am, but I rather doubt the good people of Namai would take kindly to the sight of a man in Imperial uniform with blood still dripping from his blade. Even in your company, my presence will only prove a distraction. Right now, however. Thanks to the three of you, I have seen a great deal more than I otherwise would. And with any luck, Lord Heen will have finished considering my proposal by the time we returned. Thank you again for agreeing to join me. If not for your aid, the Kojin may well have overwhelmed us. Pray go on ahead. Lord Heen is expecting you. I will remain without and keep watch over our guests. Well, we had best not keep him waiting. Welcome back, my friend. Yugiri tells me you accompanied her and Asashi on a tour of Zansha. I'd hoped you might take the opportunity to recover from your exertions at Sakazuki. But I gather your time was well spent, until the ambassador afforded Yugiri a chance to make a full report. However, I must rely on you to supply the details. So please, tell us how it all unfolded. The Red Kojin? Here? Have there been any other such incidents since the liberation? Not that I'm aware of. If they are planning some new venture here in Zansha, we will need to increase patrols. In any event, I am indebted to you for fighting them off. But tell me, and don't be modest, was Asahi truly the first to leave to the youngster's aid? He was. I was quick to doubt him when we first met, but his desire to save them seemed quite genuine. It's possible he truly believes what he's saying. In the time I've known you, you have always been an excellent judge of character. What do you make of the ambassador? Then the question of what his true intention may be remains. Regardless of his aim, I am resigned to playing his game. For now, at least. Well, forswearing summoning should be simple enough, considering you Neville dabbled it in the first place, which just leaves the somewhat thornier question of how to police the Red Kojin. It was with that very question in mind that I saw Alphino's counsel. Thanks to his knowledge of the icons and the rituals used to invoke them, I believe we've identified a workable solution. As you will recall, Susanoo was summoned forth using the power of relics, locked away in the Kojin's treasure vault on the Isle of Zeki. Though said relics remain there to this day, It is all but certain that the act of summoning exhausted their stores of ether, making subsequent summonings impossible. Assuming that is the case, preventing the Primal's return rests on denying the Red Kujan the means to amass new stores of ether, either via the acquisition of crystals or the relics they are wont to collect. For this, I plan to enlist the aid of our friends the Blue Kujan. Since Doma's liberation, we have forged closer bonds with Bunshin and his people, and with their support, I am quite confident we can keep the Red from obtaining what they require to call upon this Susanoo. And what of the prisoners? They will be exchanged as agreed, and I will give full credit to Asahi for the success of the transaction. If there's aught we can do to help the Populares garner favor, I mean to see it done. But first, I have some unfinished business to attend to. Would you all come with me? Yes, of course, but what matter of business? A past mistake which I would see put right, one which has weighed heavy on my mind.
I had her brought here in secret while the three of you kept our guest company. The world has not been kind to you, it is true. But that does not excuse your sins. You should be at the bottom of the river. Yet here you are. The living, breathing proof of my failure. A failure for which I would now make amends.
What did I do? I don't remember. Was it really so terrible? Tell me, please! What did I do?
You speak of sins, my lord. But at whose feet do those sins lie? With the soldiers who committed the crimes, or those who commanded them to do so? With both, I would say. For all have a conscience, and all must choose. But with no memory of who she is, or what she has done, what sin remains to be cleansed?
You ask that I show mercy?
I ask why the heavens saw fit to deny me my rest. Why Yotsuyu was spared not only death, but the bitter memories of her life.
You truly think it the will of the Kami? If so, her life is not mine to take. It is yours to safeguard. Come the hour of the exchange, if her memories have not returned, she may remain here in Doma to live out her days as Tsuyu. But if they do, the Garlians shall have their viceroy. Though the people will protest, they will come to accept my decision when they have been reunited with their loved ones.
Thank you, my lord.
Now then, I believe we have kept our guests waiting long enough. Did Gorsetsu not seem strange to you? His sympathy for your Tsuyu part, I mean. I know his powers of endurance only too well, but after all he has suffered, Even he should not be on his feet. He puts on a brave face for our sakes, but it would not surprise me if he lacked the strength to raise his blade. Though I suppose if he and Yotsu are to enjoy a life of peace and quiet, he will have little use for it. It falls to us to shape that future, one in which he need never again set foot on the battlefield.
With Yotsu safely in Gosetsu's care, all that remains is to answer Asahi's proposal. I realize other matters demand your attention, but I would ask that you stay a while longer to see this business through.
My apologies. Our deliberations took longer than expected.
Think nothing of it. The time afforded me the opportunity to go on a rather rousing excursion through Yansha. You have reached a decision then?
We are willing to cooperate with you in combating the Icon threat, and also in the exchange of prisoners. Assuming you accept our conditions, of course. As you know, your sister is in our care. Due to certain complications, however, we are hesitant to release her into your custody.
Complications?
She was inside Doma Castle when it collapsed. Though she survived, she remembers nothing of her past life, not even her name. To clarify, she is in our care not as a prisoner, but as a vulnerable citizen of Doma.
Are you saying you refuse to release her?
Not at all. If her memory returns before the appointed hour.
And if not, what exactly? You will accommodate her here in Doma?
Well, I sincerely doubt she will be of any great strategic value to the Empire. She spends her days daydreaming of Dango.
Dango? How dreadful. Very well. In light of our recent misstep in Sakazuki, it seems only fair that I show you the same understanding you have shown us. Though I do have one small request. Regardless of Yotsuyu's value to the Empire, she is yet my sister. Before I leave, might you permit me to speak with her in private?
Of course. Perhaps you could even bring her a plate of dango. She would be most pleased. Yugiri will see you to her chambers.
Forgive me, my lord, but has he not been gone over long? Perhaps I should... Calm yourself, Gosetsu. I understand your concern, but we have to wait. He deserves that much. I am sorry to have kept you all waiting. Thank you for your understanding. Long did I dream of this reunion, but never did I imagine it would be so joyless. A part of me hoped your stories of her condition were just that. Alas, it is as you say. Tsuyu, do you remember anything of this man? Anything at all?
No.
I am a stranger to her. That much was clear to me from a single look. I'll leave her in your care. As you wish. Now, if you'll excuse me, my superiors are long overdue a report. They will be elated to hear of our agreement, of that I have no doubt. As for the exchange itself, once I've obtained the relevant permissions, I will arrange for your people to be relieved of their various duties and sit here to Yansha. This will take time, of course. Of course. You may rest assured your soldiers will be well cared for until your return. We will also begin taking steps to better counter the threat of the Kojin and their icon. Before you take your leave, there is one other matter. I am informed it was you who took the lead in rescuing two young Domans from a band of Kojin sellswords. I have not yet had the time to thank you properly. Please, there is no need to thank me. I only did what anyone would do under those circumstances. Fortunately, I was in good company at the time. The blight of the Red Kojin is of the Empire's making. Were it not for our transgressions, those children would not have needed saving. The people of Doma have suffered enough, my lord, and I promise to do all my power to spare them further pain, be it at the hands of the Kojin, or indeed the Empire. I pray the Empire will see things as you do. There may yet be hope for us all. Until we meet again. Gosetsu, as before, I leave Yotsuyu to you. I invite the rest of you to join me outside. Let's treat Asahi to a proper farewell. The ambassador's airship awaits a Castrum Fluminus. Let us be off.
I wish you a safe journey.
This has been a most enjoyable visit. I look forward to our next meeting. Maxima, would you take the others and see that all is ready for our departure? I simply cannot leave without first giving thanks to the Warrior of Light for accompanying me through Yansha. Mark me, savior of the savages. There will be a reckoning.
Traitor!
Ignorant savages! Killing us will avail you naught. For every Imperial you cut down, 1,000 more will come. Abandon this foolish endeavor and surrender. You may yet serve our righteous cause.
Ha! How dare you speak of righteousness? You who forsook kith and kin to serve conquerors! Be glad I grant you this mercy. What in the... Reinforcements? No, just one! Cut him down!
Thank you, sir.
This one is promising. Who remains to offer us resistance?
A host of rebels led by Lord Cayenne hold the Enclave across the river.
Lord Cayenne.
The king of the former king of Dorma, sir. They say he is one of the greatest swordsmen alive.
Is that what they say?
Surely you jest. That was Xenos Yegalvus, Legatus of the 12th, the Crown Bloody Prince. I heard he was strong, but that was frightening. That was Lord Xenos.
Everything you are, your power, even your face, it vexes me. Go on. Lash out like the beast you are at an emissary and jeopardize the newfound peace between Dorma and the Empire. My lord was destined to lead us unto a glorious new age. Your light is nothing to his radiance. I will cherish this moment, lock it away within my heart, until the day we meet again.
You look troubled, my friend. Was it something he said?
Of all the memories to witness.
I had my doubts about him, but I would never have guessed he was a disciple of Zenos. My lord.
Calm yourself, Yugiri. I set no store by him or his enlightened brethren. But if by treating with them there is even the faintest hope we might secure the return of our conscripted brothers and sisters, I must play this game. After the way I risked their lives in the rebellion, I owe them that much.
My lord, you bear no blame for their fate.
If not blame, then responsibility. They were prisoners, and still I chose to fight, knowing they could be executed in retaliation. But now we have a chance to bring them home. If it means bargaining with a monster, so be it.
My lord.
Besides, I think he likes me, which is more than some can say.
It makes no sense. Why would he bother keeping up the pretense for so long, only to drop it right before the very end? Perhaps he no longer thought it necessary, having secured Doma's cooperation in the prisoner exchange. If he truly is a disciple of Zenos, 'tis possible emotion simply got the better of him. Remaining calm around the woman who slew his lord will have taken its toll. Whatever the explanation, now is not the time for hasty reprisals. We shall proceed as planned. The Red Kojin must be placed under surveillance, and the Garlean prisoner is made ready for the exchange, but you need not concern yourself with the details. Leave the affairs of Doma to us. When the hour of the exchange draws near, we will call for you. I should certainly hope so. Whatever the Empire's true intent, we will be on hand to play our part, either to defend Doma or to help usher in a lasting peace. I had thought we might use this time to return to Eorzea, but given the volatility of the situation, mayhap it would be best if we remained in Kugane. Agreed. Between Yotsuyu's amnesia and Asahi's dubious agenda, I'd say we have ample reason to remain in the neighborhood. If anything should happen, anything at all, you must send for us at once. Oh, I will. On that, you have my word. Charting a path through the Sea of Troubles promises to be difficult enough. I'm not so proud as to attempt the feat alone. To Kugane, then. Tataru and the others must know of what transpired here. My, it seems you're all in quite a predicament. Well, should we receive any urgent missive from Doma, rest assured you will be the first to know of it.
Yes, of course. We're discussing ideas to replenish our coffers, but I suppose that all can wait if any urgent news should come through the office.
About that, I wish to apologize to Taru. It was reckless of me to make such a purchase without first consulting you. You may be certain, however, that I mean to reimburse the Scions, even if it means drawing upon my personal funds.
That's very thoughtful of you, but I'm sure it won't come to that.
If Soroban's business proposition is as promising as it sounds, Alara should have no difficulty wiping the red from our ledger. Forgive me, Alara. It would seem I have unwittingly heaped my financial troubles upon you. I swear I will pay you back. Though I fear I will struggle to cobble together anything of monetary value, knowledge I can gather in abundance. To start, I plan to investigate the divisions forming within the Empire. Mayhap Riol and his associates have heard something on the subject. Regardless, the more we know about the politics of Garlemald, the better our chances of predicting the Imperial's next move, which might yield you on an advantage on the day of the prisoner exchange. Knowing what we do of Asahi's apparent resentment towards you, I cannot say what he hopes to gain from it. But if there is even the faintest chance that a lasting peace could be forged between Doma and the Empire, what choice have we but to try? Lord Heian had the right of it. Asahi may very well be a monster, but we must play his game. For now. Arranging the prisoner exchange proved easier than I thought. Yes, my lord. We'll be most pleased. Everything is going according to plan.
Can you truly remember nothing? Nothing at all.
Were we friends?
Yes! We were good friends, you and I. In fact, I've brought you a gift. I pray that one day soon, as you gaze into that mirror, you will remember the woman staring back at you.
It's so pretty. Who are you?
Meanwhile, in the Imperial capital,
how are you feeling, my lord?
Fine, now leave me.